The idea of the human body as a canvas is not new. The history of art should definitely include chapters on body art, given how ancient and even mythologically related it is. Currently, though, tattoos, body piercings, and nail art are seen as the hot new trends.
A new kind of artist lurks around the fashion block. His material is organic. What he works on and develops is made out of flesh. He's the tattoo artist. Tattoos are now the urban youth's latest adornment. The code gender-wise seems to be men with monochrome black and symbols, tribal or Celtic, women with color and figures, mostly gothic or nature-based.
Women do more of the tattoos on the lower backs and their shoulder backs. They do tattoos like dolphins and butterflies and goblins and mushrooms. And the men do more tattoos which are on the tribal side, and they do it on the arm.
A 25,000-year-old art form first practiced among African tribals, tattooing has evolved to fit fashion and lifestyle in the contemporary urban world.
People used to feel tattoos, pain, but what we do is we use in a cream which we put it on their body 2 hours before having the tattoo, and it does not hurt you at all.
The artist's raw material has expanded from vegetable dyes, ink, needles and paint to include crystal and jewels.
Indian tattoo art is going to catch up more abroad also, because we had more of Indianized tattoos like Shiva, Buddha and all the gods, Ganesha. People love to look at our art.
The genre of body art is not limited by the size of its canvas. The human nail, for instance, is not too small for the creative expression of these professionals. In suburban Mumbai, this is India's first nail bar. Here, all kinds of designs in all sorts of colors and textures can be custom created for clients on nail extensions.
Initially, it started with the glamour class basically coming in for nails, but now it has moved on to the middle class and the upper middle class also wanting to do it. It's more becoming a grooming thing than a fashion statement. We're doing all different types of nail art. Now there are two sides to it. One is nail extensions, in which we're doing acrylic, gel, and now we've started silk. Then is the nail designing, which is optional. We're doing different types of nail design to basically suit your outfit or the occasion. If it's a marriage, it's a different design. If it's a very sober look, then mostly people go in for French. It all depends on the occasion.
Not quite as painless as nail art is body piercing. Piercing leaves metal rings or pins in key places on the body. Not as permanent as a tattoo, a body piercing is arguably more invasive though.
It swelled up and I couldn't talk. My lip also swelled up for like 2 days or something. I couldn't talk, I couldn't eat properly. That was there. And tongue again. I couldn't talk for 2 days properly. I'm talking to people, they couldn't understand what I'm saying, and it did hurt. They numbed my tongue. That thing hurt. You know, but now it's okay. There are people who are just following it just because it's an in thing, as so to say, you know. Just, they have their eyebrow also, they have their lip also, they have everything pierced, you know. Those kind of people have it. I mean, if they want to do so much, they do it. But there are certain people, sensible people, they have it balanced, you know. They have like just a few which they can, you know, handle.
Nail size but with much more bite is the human tooth. Sterilized blue and white crystals gummed onto one's molars can truly add a sparkle to the smile. More cosmetic than some other forms of body art, these crystals can be as easily removed as placed.
Small blue is the most in thing, you know, people prefer that because that contrast of white and blue is there,
and also the small, they are initially not so adventurous, so they prefer a smaller one. Sometimes then they come back and no, now put the large one.